So it's time to talk about authorship. As you know, in science, authorship is really important. So authorship is how you build your CV. It's how you get your next job. It's how you get promoted. It shows your record, your productivity. So being an author on a scientific paper is a really big deal. It's such a big deal that it's a leading source of conflicts in the academic world. And so that's why it's really important to start talking about authorship now, before you start writing your paper. What you should do is have everyone who has been involved in the project in on a meeting or an email chain, and everyone needs to contribute and agree on who the authors are going to be and in what order they're going to be listed. The order of the authors is also important in most scientific fields. So decide on this before you start writing. Now, who should not be an author? Just because somebody worked on the project doesn't mean they automatically earn authorship. They need to have significant intellectual contributions to the work to become an author. Now, let me give you an example. Maybe you hired a research student who you're paying by the hour, and they're collecting a lot of data for you and putting it into an Excel sheet or writing it down in a notebook. Does that student worker earn authorship on the paper? No, they do not, unless they have contributed something more than just collecting data. One thing that's important is that all of the co-authors are going to read and approve the final version of the manuscript. One thing you should do is look at your target journal and see if they have guidance on authorship. Now, we're going to look at some guidance for authorship now. This is put out from the International Committee of Medical Journal Editors, who publishes the uniform requirements for manuscripts submitted to biomedical journals. Now, these uniform requirements can be applied to other disciplines. They don't have to only be for biomedical journals. So let's take a close look at this authorship statement. Authorship should be based on the following four criteria. Point number one, substantial contributions to the conception or design of the work, or the acquisition, analysis, or interpretation of data for the work. And number two, drafting the work or revising it critically for important intellectual content. And point number three, final approval of the version to be published. And point number four, agreement to be accountable for all aspects of the work in ensuring that questions related to the accuracy or integrity of any part of the work are appropriately investigated and resolved. In other words, if there's someone on the team who did plagiarism or fabrication or falsification of some of the data, everyone on the team is responsible for that. You can't just blame that other person and say it's not my fault. Everyone is responsible. Let's continue reading this statement. In addition to being accountable for the parts of the work he or she has done, an author should be able to identify which co-authors are responsible for specific other parts of the work. In addition, authors should have confidence in the integrity of the contributions of their co-authors. Now, some journals ask the authors to make a statement of contributions of the individual contributors. And that statement is usually somewhere near the acknowledgments at the end of the article. The final sentence of the statement is, all those designated as authors should meet all four criteria for authorship, and all who meet the four criteria should be identified as authors. Those who do not meet all four criteria should be acknowledged. In summary, these authorship rules are quite strict, and if you want to follow ethical publication practices, you should pay close attention to these guidelines. The order of the author names is also quite important for journal articles. And I should point out that different fields have different conventions. For example, some fields in science list all the authors alphabetically, regardless of who contributed the most, who contributed the least, and who is the head of the laboratory. But for most of the life sciences, these are the typical author order conventions. The first author is the person who contributed the most to the research, and usually they're also the lead author. They did most of the writing. The last author is typically the head of the laboratory, and the corresponding author is usually the first author or the last author. Now, sometimes there are co-first authors. This is when two people made an equal contribution to the work that's being published. And so there's typically an asterisk by their name stating that these two people contributed equally. However, on the piece of paper, somebody's name is going to be first. And so it's important that you talk about whose name is going to be listed first, even in the case when there are co-first authors.